Subscribe and hit the bell icon to never miss an update from eTimes TV.
Welcome Madhura. Welcome to eTimes TV. This is Sukarna. Glad to have you here today.
Thank you.
So tell us the burning question, like the entire, the picture and the article went viral. What made you put up that graphic bikini pictures and captioning it as creeps who have been asking for it?
Did it really go viral?
Yes, I'm afraid so.
Yeah, so basically I was just, out with my cousins at my cousin's house, and we were just having fun, and you know, one of my friends from Israel, he sent me a picture of mine, like a cartoon picture, graphic picture of mine in bikini. As soon as I saw it, I thought, oh my God, I have to post this, because my DMs and my inbox is full of such messages from creeps. You know, I mean, I don't know how to react to those messages. Usually I just don't open them, but I've kind of read them. So I wanted to put this bikini picture out for all of them, because I have so many of these messages, and I get so, disgusted by people and what they write. And sometimes I wonder if they were face to face with me, would they say the same thing to me? Would they have the guts or the courage to say that to me?
And how have your fans and friends reacted to that picture after you put it up on social media?
My friends were laughing. All my friends were just laughing. All my friends commented with, you know, the hi-fi emoji and the bow down emojis. So yeah, all my friends were laughing at the joke. It was a joke.
So Madhura, being a celebrity, like, just for knowledge, like, how many such lewd or harassing DMs do you get, or average on a day?
I get so many of these messages, not even funny. Some of them are really disrespectful. Some of them are just weird, outright weird. So as a celebrity, as a public figure, we are always exposed to such things. And I think everyone just should know how to deal with it. Everyone deals with it differently.
Yeah, my next question was, like, social media abuse is rampant nowadays, like, especially with celebrities. How do you deal with it? How do you get past it?
Yeah, for me, it doesn't affect me mentally. I just sometimes think that, what if this person was in front of me? Would this person have the courage to say the same things that they say behind the mobile phone? You know, it's very easy to text such things, or like just write down a message, and send it from a fake account. Obviously, we won't know who it is, who's writing to us. And, you know, hiding behind the phone is a very easy thing to do. It's for cowards. But would they do this to me if they were in front of me? That is the question. And if they did, they will definitely have consequences.
But kabhi aise real life mein, have you faced any such comment?
No, not in real life. Never in real life. I think when people are in front of you, or in front of anybody, the person gauges what kind of a person would this girl or this man be, you know? I mean, sometimes you have like a sixth sense or an intuition that if I say something off to this person, maybe I will get trashed for it. So maybe I give out those vibes. So nobody's ever tried these kind of stunts with me yet.
So, there's a trend on social media going nowadays that ignore no more. Like, celebrities, women are calling out and reporting such harassers on social media. Do you really believe or agree that like calling them out or reporting such people will actually help or change their mentality?
Yeah, of course. I feel like everyone should, instead of blocking or just deleting the comment, we should obviously report the account. That's the reason why we are given a report button. And when you report such accounts, it goes into the algorithm of a Facebook or Instagram or YouTube or whatever. And I'm sure they take desired action against them.
But
so I feel like people should report such accounts. Of course, nobody has the time in real life to go to a cyber police or go up to a police station unless it gets really, really out of hand. But otherwise, we have like the report icon right next to such accounts, and then you can just claim like this person has harassed you, whatever. I think it's important to report these accounts because, I mean, we're not very pro in terms of cybercrime yet in India, but I feel like there are ways to deal with it.
And talking about cyberbullying, have you ever faced it?
Me, I have only faced a lot of hate comments when I, you know, probably share my political views. For instance, something that happened recently with between Israel and Palestine. And I have a lot of friends in Palestine and they sent me some pictures and I felt very sad because it was the day of Eid. So I made a post and I got such a backlash on my Instagram. And I mean, a lot of people have a lot of views and then they write you these hate comments and then they have so many things to say to you because they know you will reply back. And sometimes it's important to reply back to these people because, you know, they need to know. Like, as a person or as a human being, I have liberty to have my views, which not necessarily align with yours. So, I've got a lot of hate comments on political posts. I've got a lot of hate comments on one of my posts where I was out fishing with my cousins. And for me, it doesn't affect my mental state. For me, I just sit back, read the comments and laugh it out. I'm like, what kind of people are these? Like, if you had a view and if you had a logical view, I would, you know, agree to disagree. I wouldn't write you hate comments or say that I'm going to unfollow you, I'm going to do this and I'm going to do that. And they go all over the place. So for me, I have a good laugh.
Fishing picture mein why hate comments?
So you know, a lot of us are vegetarians, a lot of us are non-vegetarians, and for me, from where I have come, where I have been brought up, fishing was always a sport. Not that we're killing for fun, but it's just, you know, I mean, we fish, we remove the fish, and then we put it back in the water because we're not going to take it back home and cook it and eat it. But for us, you know, it's considered a sport, and people didn't take it very well because I posted a picture of my catch. Like, I caught a fish and I caught it and I took a picture of it. Maybe it hurt sentiments of a lot of Indians who, you know, abstain from eating non-veg, but I didn't know how to react to it. I was just trying to be sensitive and I said, okay, fine. I mean, everyone has their own likes and dislikes. Maybe it was a little insensitive, but I don't know. I can't say I'm sorry for it because from what kind of upbringing I've had, I've always thought of it as a sport. Now it's very difficult to condition my mind to think something else.
And like moments like these, when you receive backlash for like anything, like you are sharing moments from your personal life or sharing your persona, do you think twice, or like being a celebrity, do you think twice before posting anything on the social media and making it public?
Yeah, honestly, you know, I don't think, because if I start thinking and filtering all my thoughts, and if I start calculating every post I'm gonna make, then I'm not gonna be me. I'm just gonna be a fake person, a made up, you know, person for people on my Instagram. I want people to like me for who, what I am, you know. So I don't like to fake, I don't like to think twice. Sometimes I will just, like, if you see my Twitter, it's filled with random quotes or random statements or random thoughts that cross my mind. And I don't feel ashamed about it, because that's who I am. I don't want to fake, be fake Madhura for my fans or for my friends or for my family. So I don't shy away from being who I am. A lot of my friends actually, you know, think before they post something. A lot of my friends, so recently one of my colleagues, he's an actor, and we were all having dinner at his farmhouse, and you know, I said, hey, let's, we were going to post a picture, and I posted a picture, and he really wanted to post a picture too, and he said, I really want to post it, Mads, but I don't want to post it right now. I said, why? So he said, you know, in times of corona, if we post a picture, you know, a happy picture, people will think that we're just having fun, we're just having, you know, holidays while others are suffering or whatever. But I don't see it like that. I mean, everyone has suffered in this pandemic. I have too. I had COVID as well. And sometimes we don't post negative pictures. We post happy pictures because we want to spread happiness. You know, you can't, when everybody's fighting through such a tough phase, you can't keep posting negative things. You have to post happy things and let people be happy if you're happy. I don't know, maybe someone will just get motivated looking at your happy posts. So I don't believe in filtering and, you know, all of this. I know a lot of celebrities got bashed and thrashed for vacationing while in a pandemic, and a lot of hatred was thrown at them. But you know, like I say, not everybody knows what goes behind the camera, right? So it's what they want to show you. What they want to show you, I think people should just look at it and enjoy if they are, you know, fond of them.
During the first phase of lockdown, people were sharing hobbies and everything. And second wave, the time, like, people got more conscious about what they are posting on social media.
Yeah, I noticed that as well. A lot of my friends were conscious in the second lockdown. The first lockdown, everyone was posting, like, you know, inspirational, motivational. People were working out, people were painting, people were singing, people were cooking. So that's a good thing. I see it as a positive thing. I don't see it as, you know, something negative or something people should hate you for.
Okay, chalo. Thank you so much, Madhura, for being with
You're
us
welcome.
Today. Bye. Take care.
Bye.
Stay safe and get vaccinated
soon.
Get home. I hope.
Yeah. All right. Chalo. Bye. Bye. Ciao.